are working in a medical sector, then you will get a situation where you would have been given admission date and the release date, and you would be asked to calculate for how many days the patient was admitted, something like this. Or if you are working in finance industry, you might have been given application date for the loan and the current date, and you will have to calculate how many months it has it been when customer was acquisition. So, welcome to the channel Learn Area. To understand the concept very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe and hit the bell icon. Today we're gonna see the third part in the date series, and under that we would learn int CK function. As we saw in the previous example, this is quite clear that it is used to calculate the difference between two dates, times, or two date and times. Okay, let's look at the definition. Its definition suggests calculates the difference between two dates, times, or date times, as I mentioned previously. So how does its syntax go? It's something like this, meaning you would have to write int CK, then start the parenthesis operator, and then put the intervals. What all could be the intervals, I'll show you in just next slide. For now, just understand that we need to provide interval. Okay, for example, the interval could be months. I mean, how many months, the difference is in how many months between two dates. Then you'll have to provide start date and then end date. And this is method, which is the optional parameter, which I will explain as we progress with the videos. Okay, so let's go to the SAS session and try doing this. Okay, let's create a sample data set, or I already have created this over here. I'm just gonna remove this thing, or let me just put it over here quickly, and then this, and I'm gonna put it here, and you can just come into this. Okay, now let's run this syntax. Here you have been given four date values. One is admission date, discharge date, application date, current date, just to be in the sync of our previous example. Now, two things we have to calculate. First thing which we need to calculate is the difference between these two dates, this and this. And this difference we need to calculate in number of days. Second example, we will try calculating the difference between this date and this date, and this difference we will calculate in number of months. So let's go to the program and try doing this. First we're gonna calculate for how many days a patient was admitted or hospitalization days. Okay, then start int CK. Here we have to calculate the difference in number of days. So in double quotes, or you can put that in single quotes, what all could be the interval, we will just see in next step. For now, in double quotes, you need to provide day, then the starting date, which was admission date. I will just copy it from here and put it here. Then you need to provide the end date, discharge date. Okay, and just run this. Something went wrong, semicolon. Let's run this now. Current date, what is wrong with this program? Hospitalization days, testing. Let's figure it out, what's wrong with this video, not video, means this program. The syntax was slightly incorrect. I will just correct this. Now here you see the difference in number of days, the difference is 20. Similarly, similar thing you can do over here to calculate months on book. For the ease of convenience, I am just going to copy this and put it over here. Just change the start date and end date. Close the bracket, end with semicolon. This time we have to calculate the difference in months, as the requirement says months on book, how many months it has passed when the customer took this loan. So this time interval is going to be month. Alright, now let's run this. So here you can see the number of months which it has passed are 9. Okay, so this is how you can calculate the difference between two dates. Similarly, you can calculate the difference between two time and date and time. The all that you need to be careful is providing the interval thing and just calculate the difference between two values, which the values could be date, time, date or time or date times. Now let's look at the intervals. What all are the intervals we have been given in SAS to calculate the differences? The intervals are these date intervals. These all are the date intervals. These are the date time intervals and these are time intervals. So you just don't have to do anything. Just pick any interval value. For example, week. Just come over here and put week. For how many weeks the patient was admitted? Just check it out. 3 weeks. He was admitted for 3 weeks. So similarly, you can use any of these things. For example, if you have to use semi-year, for how many semi-years the customer was, how long it has been when the customer got acquired? Semi-year. Let's run this. And just one semi-year. Alright, so this is how you can this is how you can calculate the difference using all of these intervals, any one of these intervals. Now it comes to method. What are the methods? So there are two methods we can use in INT-CK. What are those methods? First one is discrete, second one is continuous. When we say discrete, that means it calculates the difference on the interval boundaries. For example, if we have been given the start date as 31st of December 2019 and end date is 1st Jan 2020, and if you see the difference in month is zero, if you will see actually the difference in month is zero, but it provides you one when you use the discrete method, because here it's a change in month. So wherever the change in month, and if you are using the discrete method, then you will get the result in terms of month. But if you are using continuous, you will get the result as zero, because it takes the exact count from starting from the start date, right? Starting from the first date, and it takes the exact count in terms of days, and then it calculates the months, right? So if you see over here, the difference in days is just one, but if you take that in terms of months, that will become zero. So this is what the difference between discrete and continuous. Let's go and try this over here. I'm just going to create another date. Start date equals to 31st December 2019. End date equals to 1st Jan 2020. Okay. And let's calculate the difference. Difference we want to see just put, let me put D over here so that it could become date 9 format. Difference we want to see in months. So let's put month and start date, then end date. Okay, and see, discrete method is the default method. If you don't put anything over here, it applies the discrete method. But if you put some if you want to change it to continuous, you just need to put the alias in the form of this, either C or CONT. Okay, so here I am just not putting anything so that first we could experience the discrete method. So this will show you the difference as 1. So if you can see, again there is something wrong. I didn't put the function name int ck. Sorry for that. Now you can see the difference is 1. I just didn't apply the format over here because, okay, let me just put the format as well. Copy this and put it over here, then end date. Okay, now let's run this. If you see, the start date is 31st December and end date is 1st Jan. And then if you see, for that the difference is 1 because it is using the continuous method. Now let's change this method. Sorry, it was using the discrete method, that's why it showed the difference as 1. Let's change the method to continuous. Whenever you are putting some method, you need to put that between the quotation. It could be double quotation or the single quotation. Let's run this. Now you see the difference is 0 because you use the continuous method. So this is how you can use the int ck function to calculate the difference between two dates, times, or date and times. Okay, so thank you very much for watching the video. Wish you